Imagine if you could create any voice just by describing it.
A warm bakery owner.
A movie trailer voice.
Even a whispering cookie thief.
Well, that's exactly what Hume AI does. Hume AI is a brand new AI voice generator that converts text to realistic sounding speech. And the best part? You can use it entirely for free. Let's listen to an example.
Welcome to the Kevin Cookie Company, where every bite is baked to perfection. Would you like a warm, gooey chocolate chip cookie?
That voice, it's not real. It was generated entirely by AI. They claim to be the most realistic yet, even more so than ElevenLabs, the market leader in the space. Can it actually replace a human voice? I partnered with Hume to find out. Let's dive in. To try this out for yourself, head to the following website. You get 10 free minutes of AI-generated voice per month, and I'll show you how to make the most of it. You can start generating voices directly on the homepage. On top, you can describe the voice that you want, and below, you can type in your script that you would like the voice to narrate. Feel free to experiment with it right here. To get the full interface though, let's click on Go to App, and then let's set up an account. Once you finish setting up your account, this drops us into the main interface. To start generating voices, over on the left-hand side, let's click into the playground. Within the playground, right in the center of the screen, you can type in the text that you would like an AI voice to narrate. Here, I'll type in some copy about the Kevin Cookie Company. Over on the right-hand side, we have various settings, and in a little bit, we'll get to them. But before we do that, down at the very bottom, let's simply click on Generate.
Welcome to the Kevin Cookie Company. Our cookies are so good, even your grandma will ask for the recipe, and will politely refuse.
Wow, that actually sounded surprisingly good and really natural. You might be wondering, why did it pick that voice? Right up in the top right-hand corner, we didn't specify a voice. What Hume does is it reads all the text, and it makes a best guess at what type of voice would be most appropriate to narrate this. However, we can also specify a voice if we have something in mind. Over on the right-hand side, within Voice, let's click on this button that says Select Voice. This opens up all of the different preset voices, and you have many, many different voices that you could choose from. Now, you could go through here and listen to them and go with one of these. However, you can also click on Create Voice, and you can make any voice that comes to mind. Let's listen to a few of these examples here. Let's start with maybe the evil undead vampire. That sounds really ominous.
I vanned to bite your neck.
Ooh.
And drink your blood.
Oh, please don't do that. Right down here, we have the friendly troll.
We won't go outside and play with shiny red ball, but we know can find it nowhere.
Okay, Grendel, let's go through and maybe listen to a few more. Here we have a shouting voice.
Hey, you there, what do you think you're doing? Get back in line, now.
Okay, I'm sorry, just recording a YouTube video here. Right down here, we have Terrence Bentley.
Yo, Southside Chicago was my classroom, and life was the hardest textbook I ever had to study.
Nice, okay, let's listen to a few more. Here we have the whispering guy.
Psst. Did you know that the library is haunted? Or so the legend goes.
Let's try this serious movie trailer.
In a world teetering on the brink of destruction, one man will rise to face the ultimate challenge.
You're probably now starting to get a sense for all the different voices that you could choose from. And again, these are just the preset voices, and you could also design your very own voice as well. Let's go back to the fifth page here, and let's have a listen to the sitcom girl.
Okay, so like, picture this. I'm trying to parallel park, and suddenly my brain's giving me a play-by-play, like I'm in the Super Bowl or something.
That really does sound like a sitcom girl. Let's try this voice and have her narrate the text that we typed into the playground. I'll click on this. Now that we've selected a voice, down below, let's click on Generate again, and that'll now apply that voice to the text that we typed up above.
Welcome to the Kevin Cookie Company. Our cookies are so good, even your grandma will ask for the recipe and will politely refuse.
That sounded okay, but the voice doesn't quite match the text that we have up above. At least in my mind, a voice like that usually speaks a little bit differently. To the left of the Generate button, we have another button that says Enhance Text. When we click on this, this adjusts the text to match the voice that we selected. Let's try this. Right up above, we can see the changes that it made to our text. Hey, welcome to like the Kevin Cookie Company. Our cookies are like so good. Now, this matches my expectations much more for a sitcom girl. I would expect her to speak more like this. And here we have we have some of those filler words inserted in. And now that it's enhanced the text, down below, if we don't like that change, we could always undo it. But I'd like to hear what this sounds like. So let's click on generate once again.
Hey, welcome to like the Kevin Cookie Company. Our cookies are like so good. Even your grandma will ask for the recipe and we'll politely refuse.
That is spot on. That fits the voice so much better. It's funny how our mind has an expectation for how a voice should speak. Now that we've played with a few of these preset voices, let's try making our own. Over here, let's undo these changes, and that brings the text back to what I originally had. Then, up in the top right-hand corner where we have the voice, let's click on Change. This once again opens up all of the different preset voices. To the right of that tab, we have another one for voice design, and it looks like I haven't actually created any voices yet. So right up here, let's click on Create Voice. This opens up a prompt where we can design a voice. Right up on top, we can type in text that we would like the voice to say. And again, if we leave it just like this, Hume will determine what voice works the best for the text that you entered in. However, if you want even more control, down at the bottom, there's another text field for a voice prompt. And this is where you can describe or type out what you want this voice to sound like. Now, I have something very specific in mind. I'll type in my text, and I think having a Willy Wonka-style narrator would fit really well for a cookie company. So here, I'll type in my voice prompt. Right down at the bottom, we can now generate some samples to see which voice we like the most. Let's try this. It's now generated three different samples. Let's have a listen.
Welcome to the Kevin Cookie Company. Our cookies are so good, even your grandma will ask for the recipe.
Okay, not bad. Sounds a little bit more professional than I'd like. Let's try the next one.
Welcome to the Kevin Cookie Company. Our cookies are so good. Even your grandma will ask for the recipe.
Okay, that sounds like a playful male, doesn't take life too seriously. I think that's a leading contender so far. Let's listen to the third one.
Welcome to the Kevin Cookie Company. Our cookies are so good. Even your grandma will ask for the recipe.
Okay, I think I like number two the most. Now, one thing you can do is if for whatever reason you decide you don't like these three different samples, you can come right back up above and you could expand upon your voice prompt. The more detailed you are, the closer you'll get to what you have in mind. Then down below, you could generate some additional samples. I like sample number two though, so I'll click on this and down below, I can give my voice a name. This way I can use this voice again in future projects. I'll simply call it the Kevin Cookie Company spokesperson. That way we have a consistent voice in all of our different copy. Then down below, let's click on Save Voice. Now that I saved my voice, in the top right-hand corner, I can see that that voice is currently active. When I click on Generate, it'll now use that voice.
Welcome to the Kevin Cookie Company. Our cookies are so good. Even your grandma will ask for the recipe, and we'll politely refuse.
Over on the right-hand side, we can also provide acting instructions. With this, you can tell this voice how you want it to narrate this text. Let's try something here. Maybe we want it to whisper in a very light voice, almost like you're telling someone a secret, and only the person next to you should hear what you're saying. Once you type in your acting instructions, down at the bottom, let's click on Generate again.
Welcome to the Kevin Cookie Company. Our cookies are so good, even your grandma will ask for the recipe and will politely refuse.
Once you're all done tweaking your AI voice, you can now download the output. Over on the right-hand side, you can download it as an MP3, and this is a compressed audio file. Or you could download the highest possible quality with a WAV file. Make your selection, then down at the bottom, you can download the output. Let's now try this same line of text in ElevenLabs. With ElevenLabs, we have similar functionality. Over on the left-hand side, we have voices, and if I click on this plus icon, I can add a new voice. Over here, I could design my own voice by typing in a prompt. Right up on top, I'll type in my prompt, and I'll enter the same prompt that I used with Hume. Then down below, we could also type in the text that we would like to preview. And here too, I'll also type in the same text. Down below, let's click on Generate Voice. Down below, we have three different voice samples. Let's have a listen.
Welcome to the Kevin Cookie Company. Our cookies are so good, even your grandma will ask for the recipe and will politely refuse.
Let's try the second voice.
Welcome to the Kevin Cookie Company. Our cookies are so good, even your grandma will ask for the recipe and will politely refuse.
And let's try the third voice.
Welcome to the Kevin Cookie Company. Our cookies are so good, even your grandma will ask for the recipe and will politely refuse.
So, which one do you prefer? Let me know in the comments. Back in Hume, let's take a quick look at some of the additional functionality. We've been in the playground view, which works great for individual lines of narration. If, however, you have text with multiple speakers, over on the left-hand side, you might find projects helpful. With this, you can set speakers for lines of text. This is great if you want dialogue with multiple speakers going back and forth. To kick off a project, in the top right-hand corner, simply click on Create Project. Hume is entirely free to start using. You get 10 free minutes of audio generation per month. If you need more, they offer a variety of paid plans. If you use ElevenLabs, Hume's pricing is a lot better. Many of the plans are half the price. Not only do you get fantastic audio quality, but you also end up paying less. So, is this the future of AI voices? Would you use it over ElevenLabs? Let's talk in the comments. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.